In this week's episode, I'll show you more tips and tricks within Cura, and then we'll cover some new features in Cura 4.2.1, right here on Filament Friday. This week's Filament Friday is brought to you by these Patreon supporters. The first trick I want to show you is how to automatically get objects to center to your screen. Within Cura, you go up to the Cura menu and then click on Preferences. Slide down to the center camera when item is selected. Make sure that's checked, hit close, and then you should be able to select an item like the CHEP cube here, and it'll automatically center. Now if I go and click on the benchy, it centers. So I can zoom in and zoom out and it stays centered. Now I'll click on the pawn, same thing. And if I want the whole thing centered, just click on the center item and then the whole screen will be centered to that and you can zoom in and out. It's that easy. Next, I'll show you how to get Cura to automatically slice your files when you make a change. Once again, go up to the Preferences menu and there's Slice Automatically. This might be default when you installed it, but if you want to turn it off, you just uncheck it. But here, I'm going to change it to 10% infill, automatically slices. I go back and hit the reset to go back to the default 25, it automatically slices. This can be very handy. The next one is the file name prefix, and this one bugs a lot of people. So here's a CHEP pawn that I have, and it says CE3 underscore CHEP pawn. Where does that CE3 come from? Creality Ender 3, that's the machine profile I selected. If you want to get rid of that, hit Preferences, go down to Add Machine Prefix to Job Name, uncheck it. Now it won't instantly go away, it's when you do a new project. So I'll close this one, start a new project, reload the CHEP pawn. Now look at the file name. Just CHEP pawn, no CE3. Here's one that I think will help a lot of people, the Cura Settings Guide. If you click on Preferences, you'll see Settings Guide show up if it's enabled. If you don't see that, go over to Marketplace, go to Plugins, and scroll down to the Cura Settings Guide. Click on that and install it. Now mine's installed, as you see here. You install it, then you have to restart Cura, and then when you do, you can come up here to Preferences, click on Settings Guide. And this is awesome because any of the features has a very good explanation with pictures. A few of them are missing things that'll just show up as empty, but many of them have a great explanation. This is very handy, especially if you're new to 3D printing. The latest version of Cura is 4.2.1, which I believe is a beta as I make this, but there's a couple features in it that I really love. The first one is the Smart Z-Seam. I've showed the various Z-Seam options before, but under the Seam Corner Preference, there's a new option called Smart Hiding. Now what this tries to do is calculate the best place to put the seam. And most of the time I found it works really well. Now on a round object like this, it's really not much different than the random setting, but I've noticed that it is a little bit smarter depending on the print. Now this one's perfectly round, but if it's a mixture of square and round, then you'll get a different effect. But on a round object, it's like random. But here, where we've got both round and square on the benchy, here's the standard without the Smart Z seam, and it starts in the corner, multiple corners here, inside corner and outside corner, but not really a hidden corner. And so this is going to show a seam over here on the left side at that same spot every time, and you end up with a very thick wall. So now I'm going to try Smart Hiding, and you can already see it goes to an inside hidden corner. Does the same thing up here on this one, does it over here on this one, so it's always going to an inside corner, which is really hard to see the seam. Now this print also has a round smokestack, so instead of going to a corner, which doesn't exist, it goes to the random mode. So it's starting here on the outside, then it'll print actually on the inside and then outside. And when it goes outside, it'll start at a different point. So you end up with a random seam on the rounded part of this print. I think this one is going to become one of my favorite features of Cura, flow per feature. You have to enable this, but once it's enabled, you select flow. There's not only the standard flow, but every feature now has its own setting. Outer wall, inner wall, top and bottom. So I like to over extrude a little bit. like on my infill and places like that, but my outer walls always suffered from that. So now I can set the outer wall to slightly less, or 90%. I can set my infill to 110%. I can adjust my skirt or brim to really stick, 120%. I can make the support like 80% so it breaks away easy. I have individual control of every bit of the flow. So here's the Benchy with the outer flow set to 90%. So I got my solid inside, but the outer surface looks fantastic. I was trying out a new atomic filament called Candy Apple Golden Pearl PLA, and I was trying to tune it up. And when I did, I didn't use the seam on the first Benchy. So I went back and used the outer wall flow 90% and the smart hiding seam, and this came out good. I really think I got this filament dialed in. All these prints were done with my Magic 0.20 profile. You can download it from the link in the description below. I hope these tips and tricks help you get more out of Cura.